In light of our dear friend Chris Cornell passing away, we decided to play our song One More Light in honor of him to start this off. We love you, Chris. We love you, Chris.
And then the last part of the question, you're being paid tribute to. Who do you want to see out there playing a couple of your songs that you think they might put a great twist on it, or that's a band you love?
Tom Jones.
Yeah?
Absolutely.
Good choice.
It doesn't matter what song.
Right.
I think like the what would seem like the least likely one would be the best one.
Awesome. Well, Chris.
And he could do it. Like, don't kid yourself. He could sing any song.
Oh, I don't doubt it. Sure. I saw the Mars movie where his Tom Jones voice would kill the aliens.
Yeah.
His
voice is so big that sometimes you don't realize what range he has. Because he'll go up and hit these really big notes and it sounds boomy, so it doesn't sound that high.
Yeah.
That guy can sing.
Awesome. Well, thanks for hanging out. I appreciate it. And enjoy.
Everyone should have it.
I do. I have it on mine. And then
is it a good ringtone? Like, it's not annoying.
It starts off with "Show me the power." That's the part that it took.
You've got a cool little singing voice, on you?
Yeah. I would be the Eddie Vedder on Hunger Strike.
Uh-huh. It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. Don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live.
They didn't, they don't get to be part of that history, you know, and if it's ever done again, you know, we can say that we were a part of it the first time. And it was just really, everyone there from every news organization and every band felt like they were doing something that was new and important and good. And one of the questions that I think everyone got asked, you know, I heard they asked us, they asked Green Day, who were there, was, you know, okay, you have another show, you have to go then play tonight, you had to fly to come here and wake up early in the morning. It's like, is it worth it to you to, you know, to put forth so much effort to play five songs? And the lesson is that it's not hard. It's what we do. We play music every day live. That's what we do as a band. That's our job. So for us to make, you know, any kind of a difference, to just show up somewhere and play five songs, it's great. It's like, you know, it's like getting something done great and being a part of something for almost no effort. You know, it would be like a plumber fixing somebody's sink to help stamp out world poverty, or you know, the problems that some of these countries have with just like devastating starvation. We're just doing what we always do. So that's the lesson. I think, you know, everybody can learn and walk away learning from that, you know, figure out a way to do what it is that you normally do, and have some of the outcome be helping other people. That's kind of, you know, that's the lesson I came away with.
If I was a sculptor, but then again, no, or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. You can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down the words how wonderful life is while you're in. The verses, well, they've got me quite cross. But the sun's been quite kind while I wrote this song. It's for people like you that keep it turning.
so excuse me for getting. But these things I do, you see, I've forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, yours are the sweetest guys I've ever seen. And you can tell everybody this is the song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in.